Yes, so good evening, everybody. Please give me a thumbs up if I'm audible and visible to you. Please give me a thumbs up. Okay, so today we have the fourth session of Das Kadam series. Now, in Das Kadam series, today we will know about the 10 important signs as well as the eponyms in dermatology. So please give me a thumbs up if you can hear me properly. So I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, dermatology educator on an academy. And this month we are going for Das Kadam series where we will discuss the 10 important points. We had few classes. The previous session was on 10 important image-based question. Next, before that, we have 10 based images in the dermatologies. So like that, this is the fourth session of the Das Kadam series. So welcome all of you. Yes. Now before we go ahead with discussion of today's session, I just want to tell you about a iconic subscription on an academy. So this is a subscription where you have or you can access both an academy as well as prep ladder. So one second, I think the pointer option is not working. One second. Yes. Am I audible and visible to you? Please give me a thumbs up, everybody. Yes. So in Iconic's subscription, you can access to an academy as well as prep ladder. Now, what is the benefit of an academy? You can have live classes, live batch courses, live test as well as quizzes. While in case of prep ladder, you will have advantage of video lectures, question banks, and rapid revision courses. So anybody who are planning to give the NEET PG exam in 2021 or sorry 2022 can go ahead with Iconic subscription because here we have 12-month subscription which is around 4,000 rupees per month. So if you are planning to give your NEET PG in 2022, please take Iconic subscription and don't forget to use my referral code that is CHESTA10. Now, if you are planning to give your NEET PG in 2021, you can go ahead with Simple Plus subscription. Okay, and this is the cost of Simple Plus subscription where the 1 month option you have 1 month plus 2 month plus 3 month options. The 1 month is around 4,500 per month. And if you use my referral code CHESTA10, you will have additional 10% discount on that. Okay, so yes, I think we have many students who have joined. Another important notice is that on an academy we are conducting daily 20 questions and this is absolutely free for all of you. Now here we will give you 20 questions from any topic, any subject. This will help you assess yourself that which subject is stronger and which is weaker, as well as this will also tell you that where do you lie among all these students who will be giving NEET PG this year. So I request everybody to get yourself enrolled into NEET PG T20 series, okay? Because this is absolutely free for all of you every day at 8 p.m. 20 questions in 20 minutes, okay? So please get yourself enrolled into this NEET PG daily T20 series. Now, please give me a thumbs up if you're ready for the today's session. Please give me a thumbs up, everyone. Okay, very nice. Now, starting with the eponyms in dermatology, and this is the first eponym which we will discuss today. That is called as donut sign. Now, what is donut? Everybody know donut is a dessert which is somewhat like this, like a ring-shaped structure. Now, similar to donut, in case of scleromyxedema, the knuckles becomes enlarged. So, this is the normal knuckles, and if you see at this areas, because of infiltration of the knuckles with the mucine in scleromyxedema, you tend to develop something called as donut sign. So please remember this is an eponym which is compared to the food. So it is a food eponym which is used very frequently in dermatology. Very nice. Okay, so please remember even in scleromyxedema or even in case of diabetes. In case of diabetes, it is called as finger pebble. Okay, this is called as the donut sign or finger pebble in case of scleromyxedema or diabetes. Next is the putty orange appearance. This you might have read in your surgery part. Here, because of infiltration of the dermal lymphatics, the skin will become somewhat like a skin of orange. And can you see there is edema localized to the superficial dermis? It is seen in case of rosacea, pre-tibial myxedema, that is thyroid, and in case of carcinomatous infiltration of the skin. And the most common carcinoma involved here is the breast cancer. So please remember, this can be asked in the exams, that what are the PUD appearance, in which all condition you will see PUD orange appearance. So it is rosacea, pre-tibial myxedema and carcinoma and Kruse. Okay, so please remember this. You can remember the picture, you can remember the cause. Going towards the next, that is spaghetti and meatball appearance. Everybody know, where do you see spaghetti and meatball appearance? It is a classical feature of pityriasis versicolor on KOH examination. Now, can you tell me what is the another name of spaghetti and meatball appearance? Anybody? Spaghetti and meatball is usually not so much popular in our country, in India, because it is a non-vegetarian dish. So, in our country, we have replaced the spaghetti and meatball with another terminology, that is banana and grape. So, we have used or we have modified the term accordingly. Now, what is this spaghetti and meatball and what is this banana and grape? So, can you see this right picture here? In this picture, you can see there are small spores and they are long branched hyphae. So, these spores and hyphae, they give you an appearance of spaghetti and meatball or banana or grape appearance. It is very, very classical of pityriasis versicolor. Now, can anybody tell me, pityriasis versicolor, what color will it give on Wood's lamp examination? Anybody? What is the Wood's lamp color of the pityriasis versicolor? Anybody? Yes, the Wood's lamp color of pityriasis versicolor is yellow. So please remember, it will give you yellow color on Wood's lamp. And this is also a very important feature and everybody should know this. Okay. Next is the strawberry gum. Now strawberry, I think this is the fruit which is the favorite fruit of the dermatologist, because there are so many structures which are compared to strawberry in dermatology. The one which we are discussing here is Wegener's granulomatosis, where you have strawberry gums. So can you see the picture here? You can see that the infiltration of Wegener's granulomatosis, which is a small vessel vasculitis, will resemble that of strawberry. Now you also see strawberry tongue. Can anybody tell me in which condition you see strawberry tongue? I want at least two names for strawberry tongue. Anybody among you? Where do you see strawberry tongue? Yes, so please remember, strawberry tongue, it is a classical feature of Kawasaki disease and it is a feature of scarlet fever. Please remember that scarlet fever is also associated with strawberry tongue. So this is very, very important point and I think this is clear with everybody. Yes, you are right, Sneha and Mansi, you are absolutely right. It is the Kawasaki disease and the scarlet fever. Okay, so this is called as the strawberry gums. Next is the Nikolsky sign. Now, Nikolsky sign, it is a very, very important bedside investigation which is done for vesiculobullous disorder. And can anybody tell me in which vesiculobullous disorder Nikolsky sign is positive? Intraepidermal or subepidermal? Any one of you? Intraepidermal or subepidermal? Yes, so please remember, it is present only in intraepidermal vesiculobullous disorder. Okay, now what is Nikolsky sign? There is separation of epidermis on application of lateral pressure. Okay, now why there is separation of epidermis on application of lateral pressure? This is because of loss of intercellular adhesion, that is desmoglein. In case of vesiculobullous disorder, because of autoantibodies against the desmoglein, the adhesion of the cells are lost and hence the cells of the upper layer moves on the cells of the lower layer. This is called as Nikolsky sign. Now, please remember we have two type of Nikolsky sign, direct Nikolsky, which is also called as distant, and the second one is we have indirect Nikolsky, which is called as marginal. So, direct or distance Nikolsky is done over the bony prominences like elbow and knee, while indirect is done just at the adjacent or the margin of the normal or the margin of the vesiculobullous lesion. So, please remember this. This is very important. The Nikolsky sign, the Nikolsky phenomena, direct Nikolsky and indirect Nikolsky. Now, there was once a question asked that what is the significance of Nikolsky sign? So, can anybody tell me what is the significance of Nikolsky sign? What is the significance of Nikolsky sign? Yes. So, please remember the significance is it will tell you the activity of the disease. If on doing the Nikolsky sign, you see the presence of wet skin. Here you can see there is wet skin. It means that disease is active. But if on doing the Nikolsky, if it is very difficult to demonstrate or if you see the dry skin present below it, it means that now the disease is in a healing phase. So, it means it will tell you about the activity of the disease. So, I think this is clear to everybody. Please give me a thumbs up. Okay, very nice. Going towards the next point, that is called as bulla spread sign. Now, bulla spread sign is done for both intraepidermal as well as subepidermal acantholytic disorders. Both intraepidermal and subepidermal. Now, what is seen in case of intraepidermal or subepidermal or what is or how is the bulla spread sign is done? So, if you look at this clinical picture, we will mark the margins of the bulla like this. And in the bulla spread sign, we will apply a lateral pressure over the bulla. Now, if on application of lateral pressure, there is spread of the bulla, it means that the bulla spread sign is positive. Now, if the advancing border forms a pointed surface, it means that we are dealing with a case of pemphigus vulgaris. And if the advancing surface forms a round shape, then it means we are dealing with bullous pemphigoid, which is an example of subepidermal vesiculobullous disorder. I hope this is clear to all of you. No confusion here. When the advancing border is the conical border, then it is pemphigus. And if it is round, it means we are dealing with bullous pemphigoid. Okay. Now, another point is, we have one more sign which is called as Esbo-Henson sign. Now, what is this Esbo-Henson sign? It is similar to that of bulla spread sign. But what is the difference? In Esbo-Henson sign, we will apply perpendicular pressure over the bulla. While in case of bulla spread sign, we were applying a lateral pressure. Now, how to remember this? Bulla spread sign is also called as Lutz sign. So, please remember L of Lutz and L of lateral pressure. Understood all of you? No confusion here. Please give me a thumbs up if this is clear. What is bulla spread sign? What is Lutz sign? And what is Esbo-Henson sign? Very, very frequently asked in your exam. Okay? Now, next is something called as breakfast, lunch and dinner sign. Can anybody tell me this sign is positive in which dermatosis? Anybody? Where do you see breakfast, lunch and dinner sign? Very, very important, and I've seen many times this has been asked in your exam. Anybody? Yes. Please remember the breakfast, lunch, dinner sign. It is a feature of insect bite hypersensitivity or also called as bed bug hypersensitivity, or it is also called as khatmal bite. Okay, now what happens? It is observed that the insect move in a linear direction and will give three bites subsequently, and it is considered that the insect have taken his breakfast, followed by that he has taken lunch and then the dinner. And that is why this sign is called as breakfast, lunch and dinner sign. I hope you understood why it is called as breakfast, lunch and dinner sign. This is because of the three consecutive lesions which are observed in a patient of insect bite hypersensitivity, bed bug hypersensitivity or khatmal bite hypersensitivity. Okay, so please remember this. This is also a very, very important MCQs can be asked in your upcoming exam. Okay, yes. Yes, I know they have given you very interesting names for that. Anyways, going towards the next, and this is called as carpet tech sign. So can anybody tell me where do you see carpet tech sign? Anybody, where do you see carpet tech sign? And this is also called as cat tongue sign. Now please remember the cat tongue sign or carpet sign or carpet tech sign, it is characteristic of discoid lupus erythematosus. That is DLE, which is the chronic cutaneous type of LE, where you have presence of discoid lesion with central atrophy, adherent scaling and hyperpigmented margin. Now, one point you have to remember, that what is this carpet tech sign? So, I will show you a picture. Please look at this picture. This is the dermoepidermal junction. And you all know that you have hair which is coming out of the skin somewhat like this. Now what happens in case of DLE, you have thick scale which is deposited over the atrophic skin of DLE plaque. Now what happens, this scale, it has little bit downward projections over the follicular opening like this. So when you remove these scales, the undersurface of the scale will show you the downward projection. And these downward projection will give you the cat tongue appearance or carpet tech sign. Understood this? Please give me a thumbs up. I can see many students. Very nice, very nice. So this is called as carpet tech sign, which is a characteristic feature of discoid lupus erythematosus. Okay, very nice. Next is called as crow sign. Can anybody tell me in which dermatological disease you will see crow sign? Any one of you? What is crow sign and in which dermatological disease, or I can say which syndrome or which genodermatosis you see the crow sign? Anybody? Yes, please remember, crow sign, it is a feature of neurofibromatosis type 1. Crow sign is also called as axillary freckling. And please remember, this is the pathognomonic. This is the pathognomonic feature of neurofibromatosis 1. Many a time students confuse the cafe au lait spot as the pathognomonic feature of neurofibromatosis 1. But please remember, this is not the case. The pathognomonic feature of neurofibromatosis 1 is axillary freckling, which is also called as crow's sign. Is it clear to everyone? No confusion here. Please give me a bada wala thumbs up. Please remember, Vishesh and Khan, it is not seen in diabetes, not a feature of acanthosis nigricans, it is a feature of neurofibromatosis. Please give me a thumbs up if you understood this. Everybody give me a thumbs up. Yes, very nice. Next is called as the dimple sign. What is dimple sign? In case of neurofibromatosis, when you pinch the skin, because of the adhesion of the superficial skin with the neurofibroma, you tend to develop a dimple, and this is called as characteristic dimple sign. So please remember, what is dimple sign? It is a feature of dermatofibromas, and because of the teetering of the skin with dermatofibroma or attachment of the skin with dermatofibroma, there is dimpling which is seen on pinching the skin. Very, very important. It is a feature of dermatofibroma. So no, Khan, axillary freckling is not a feature of diabetes. It is a feature of neurofibromatosis. And dimple sign, it is a feature of dermatofibroma. Now, many of times student gets confused with buttonhole sign. Can anybody tell me in which condition you will see buttonhole sign? Anybody, where do you see buttonhole sign? Can anybody tell me, Mansi, Vishesh, Khan, Marwadi, anybody? Patel? Yes. So please remember, buttonhole sign is a feature of neurofibromatosis 1. Okay. So what happens if you press the neurofibromas, it just dips in and this will give a buttonhole sign. Okay. So you have two signs in neurofibromatosis. One is gross sign. Second is buttonhole sign. And buttonhole sign is different from dimple sign. Dimple sign is a feature of dermatofibroma. I hope this is clear to everybody and there is no confusion here. Going towards the next sign, which is called as the deck chair sign. Now, what is deck chair? It is somewhat like this. So, what happens? These people, they go to, they go to sea beaches and they get tan themselves. But what happens, because of sitting in these chairs, the folds of the skin get spared from the tanning process. And that type of appearance is seen in a erythroderma or a type of erythroderma which is called as papulo-erythroderma of Ofusi. Okay, so can you see there is a classical islands of sparing here? Okay, there is island of sparing here, island of sparing here. So this is because of the folding of the skin, and the skin folds will have no erythroderma. Similar to what we see when a patient or when a person goes to the sea beach for tanning. And this chair is called as the deck chair because it gets fold. It gets fold on itself. So it is called as deck chair sign, which is classical of papulo-erythroderma of Ofusi. Please remember, this was asked once in NEET PG examination. What is the deck chair sign seen in which condition? Okay. So please try to remember this sign. Very, very important. Going to the next sign, and that is called as the Darius sign. Now, what is Darius sign? It is a classical sign of urticaria pigmentosa. What is seen in case of urticaria pigmentosa? You will see hyperpigmented macules or plaque. And if you stroke one of these hyperpigmented macule, there is development of itching, erythema, as well as swelling. Now, why there is development of erythema, itching and swelling on scratching of the lesion? This is because of degranulation of the mast cell. What happens when you scratch a lesion? The mast cell get degranulate and this will release histamine, which will lead to itching, edema as well as redness. Okay, so this is a very, very classical feature of urticaria pigmentosa. But I have seen a question in PGI Chandigarh where they have asked you other example of Darius disease. So the answer is histiocytosis, leukemia and xanthogranuloma. Now there is one more entity which is called as pseudo-Darius disease or pseudo-Darius sign. Please remember, pseudo-Darius sign, it is a feature of smooth muscle hamartoma. Please remember, it is a feature of smooth muscle hamartoma, that is the Darius sign. Okay, is there any confusion? Please remember, what are the other causes of Darius sign other than urticaria pigmentosa? And please remember, where do you see the pseudo Darius sign? They can ask you this question anytime in your exams. Next is the flag sign. So flex sign, it is a very, very classical feature of nutritional disorders or protein energy malnutrition, which is called as kwashiorkor. Now, what is kwashiorkor? It is an example of protein energy malnutrition where there is hypoalbuminemia leading to edema of the body. There, these individuals will have classical discoloration of the hairs or there is alternating colors of the hair. And this is called as the flag sign. Very, very important. What is flag sign? A feature of kwashiorkor. Understood? Very, very important. Please remember. And here you have another sign, and that is called as flaky paint appearance. Flaky paint appearance. It is the dermatological disease or the exfoliation of the skin, which is very, very common in an individual of kwashiorkor. Understood? Please give me a thumbs up, everybody. What is the flag sign? Okay. Now, next is groove sign. Can you tell me where do you see the groove sign? Anybody? Where do you see the groove sign? Yes. So, please remember, groove sign, it is a feature of lymphogranuloma venereum, which is a sexually transmitted disease, and it occurs because of Chlamydia species L1, L2 and L3. So, please remember, lymphogranuloma venereum, it occurs because of the Chlamydia species L1, L2, L3. And what is groove sign? Here you have development of the, or there is enlargement of the lymph node both above and below the inguinal ligament. So this is the inguinal ligament, and you can see there is enlarged bubo just above and below the inguinal ligament. Okay, this is a very, very important feature of LGV, which is called as the groove sign. So please remember this. This can be asked in your exam. What is groove sign? What is the enlargement of the lymph node are seen against which structure? So it is seen against the inguinal ligament. Okay, so please remember this. The groove sign, it is a feature of lymphogranuloma venereum. And please remember here, the genital ulcers are usually asymptomatic. Either you have asymptomatic ulcer or you have no ulcer. You have only presence of painful lymph nodes. Okay. Now, next is the Gotron sign. Now, Gotron sign, can you tell me where do you see the Gotron sign? Anybody? Yes. So, please remember, it is a feature of dermatomyositis. What is Gotron sign? There is presence of erythema over knuckles. Then it is called as the Gotron sign. And what is Gotron's papule? What is Gotron papules? If you see presence of erythematous papules over the knuckle, then that is called as Gotron's papule. So please remember this. This is a very, very important question. What is Gotron sign? It is seen in dermatomyositis. What is Gotron papule? These are the erythematous papule present over the knuckles. So I hope this is clear to everybody. No confusion here. Yes. Now coming to Holster sign. Now can you tell me where do you see Holster sign? Anybody? Can you tell me where do you see the Holster sign? Yes. So please remember, Holster sign is also a feature of dermatomyositis. And what is Holster? It is this stand, or it is this belt which holds the gun. So, if you see, the patient is having erythema over the lateral aspect of the upper thigh, which resembles to the location of the holster. So, this is called as the holster sign, very, very classical feature of dermatomyositis. And what do you see? You see confluent reticular violaceous erythema over the lateral thigh. So it is the confluent reticular violaceous erythema of the lateral thigh, which is called as the Holster sign. Very, very characteristic of dermatomyositis. Okay, so please remember this. This is also a very, very important exam question. Next is the Hutchison sign. So what is Hutchison sign? It is seen in case of acral lentiginous type of malignant melanoma. And what does it say? That if you have involvement of the nail bed, then there is spread of the lesion or the spread of the pigment over the margins or the proximal nail fold. This is called as Hutchison sign. And this sign indicates that a patient is having underlying melanoma. So what is Hutchison sign? It is seen in case of acral lentiginous malignant melanoma, that is extension of pigment onto the nail plate or onto the proximal nail fold, very, very classical of malignant melanoma. So please try to remember this. This is also a very, very important exam question. You have one more Hutchison sign, and can you tell me what is that another Hutchison sign you know of? So another Hutchison sign is present in case of herpes zoster virus. And what is that? If you have involvement of tip of nose by herpes zoster virus, then there is a higher risk of ocular involvement. And this is because of the nasociliary nerve which is involved in this condition. So please remember this, that you have two Hutchison sign. One is malignant melanoma and another is in case of herpes zoster virus. Now next is few signs which is associated with congenital syphilis. Now what are the signs associated with congenital syphilis? One is called as the Wimberger sign. What is Wimberger sign? If you have, can you see there is hyperlucency of the epiphyseal or metaphyseal margin? This is called as Wimberger sign. And what is Higominaki sign? It is the prominence of the acroclavicular joint. So can you see the prominence of acroclavicular joint? Sternoclavicular joint. Okay. So this sternoclavicular joint prominence is called as Higominaki sign, and the Wimberger sign is called as the hyperlucency of epiphysis and metaphysis. Okay, so I think this is clear to everybody. Yes, going towards the next sign, and that is the sign of laser trillate. What is the sign of laser trillate? If you have sudden increase in the number and the size of seborrheic keratosis, it indicates that patient is having internal malignancy. And the most frequent malignancy associated with the sign of laser trillate is adenocarcinoma of the colon or the adenocarcinoma of the stomach. So please remember this point, very, very important, that what is the sign of laser trillate. I hope this is clear to everybody. This has been discussed by me frequently. The next is called as the million year sign, which is seen in case of erysipelas. Now this is a sign which differentiates the erysipelas from cellulitis. Now what is erysipelas? Here you have inflammation of the dermis. While in cellulitis, you have inflammation of the subcutaneous tissue. In case of the ear pinna, you do not see any subcutaneous tissue. So whenever a patient have involvement of face in cellulitis, the ear is spared. But in case of erysipelas, which involves the dermal component, the ear is involved. And this is called as the million's ear sign. That is involvement of the ear in case of erysipelas. Very, very important. Please try to remember it. And this is a very, very good picture which I found on internet. This can easily show you that there is involvement of the ear in case of erysipelas. Next is, or I think we are, this is the last or last second one, there is something called as Auspitz sign. What is Auspitz sign? It is seen in case of psoriasis. It has three steps. First is called as the Geratage test. While on rubbing the lesion of psoriasis with the help of glass slide, there is accentuation of scale, and this is called as the candle grease sign. On removal of these scales, you will see punctate multiple bleeding point, and this is called as Auspitz sign. So please remember, this is a very, very important sign with respect to psoriasis. Okay, so Auspitz sign is seen most frequently in chronic plaque psoriasis. It is absent in case of inverse psoriasis as well as flexural psoriasis. This is called as Pupten sign, where you can see there is conical shape of the nail plate. And it is a feature of nail lichen planus. So please remember, Pupten sign is the conical shape of the nail plate, which is seen in case of nail lichen planus. Very, very important feature. Okay. So I think this is clear to everybody. No confusion here. Okay. So I hope everybody is clear with this question. I think we should end our class and we'll meet again soon with the next session of I think I'm visible to all of you. So I will end my class here and we'll meet again with another session. I hope you understood what are the important eponyms of the dermatology, and please try to remember these signs because this can be asked very frequently in your exams. So good night, and I want you to please watch my session at 8 p.m. today. That is absolutely free for all of you on Unacademy Learning app, that is the Images of Dermatology. So bye bye.